JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for October the 6th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all but two of the other G10 currencies on Monday and during the Asian morning Tuesday. It underperformed the most against NOK, the euro and the pound in that order, while it eked out some gains only versus the Japanese yen. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the kiwi. Now, the weakening of the dollar and the yen suggests that financial markets traded in a risk-on fashion. However, the weakness in the risk-linked kiwi points otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to investors' appetite, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, major EU and US indices were a sea of green, with the positive morale rolling somewhat over the Asian session today. Japan's Nikkei 225, Hong Kong's Hang Seng, and South Korea's KOSPI gained 0.51, 0.71, and 0.28% respectively. Chinese markets stayed closed in celebration of the National Day. What may have prompted investors to increase their risk exposure may be positive updates on US President Donald Trump's health, as well as optimistic headlines over a fresh US stimulus package. The US president was tested positive for COVID-19 on Friday, but yesterday doctors treating him said that his condition is improving and sent him back to the White House, diminishing concerns over the government operating in a chaotic manner, as well as diminishing uncertainty over the November 3rd election. On the stimulus front, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi and Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin had a telephone conversation, agreeing to continue talks today in order to find common ground on legislation. White House Chief of Staff Mark Meadows said that there is still potential for an accord, and that President Trump is committed to that. As for our view, we believe that encouraging news are likely to continue supporting equities and the broader market sentiment. However, we are still reluctant to call for a long-lasting recovery. We prefer to take things day by day. Coronavirus infections continue to rise at a fast pace, with last Thursday's new global cases nearing their record, which adds to concerns over more lockdown measures around the world. On top of that, another source of concern may be the US election. As we get closer to the election day, investors may start getting more nervous. Now, overnight, apart from developments and headlines over Trump's health, we also had an RBA monetary policy decision. The bank decided to keep both the cash rate and the target of the 3-year government bond yields unchanged at 0.25%. In the accompanying statement, officials said that they continue to consider how additional stimulus could support jobs as the economy opens up further, but also noted that the decline in the second quarter output was smaller than in most other countries. They added that the labor market conditions have improved somewhat over the past few months and that the unemployment rate is likely to peak at a lower rate than earlier expected. Remember that a couple of weeks ago, RBA Deputy Governor Guy Debelle flagged the prospect of more easing, with options including currency market intervention and negative interest rates. This raised speculation that officials could hit the cut button as early as today, and thus an unchanged policy with a relatively more sanguine statement than before resulted in a higher OZ at the time of the release. However, the currency was quick to give back the decision-related gains and to trade even lower, perhaps due to the fact that officials kept the door for additional easing wide open. In any case, we believe that those traders are likely to turn their attention back to headlines and developments surrounding the broader market sentiment. As a risk-linked currency, the Aussie tends to strengthen during periods of market optimism, while it underperforms when investors trade in a risk-off manner. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the European session, the UK construction PMI for September is coming out, and the forecast points to a small decrease to 54.1 from 54.6. Later in the day, we get the US and Canadian trade balances for August. Both the US and Canadian deficits are expected to have widened somewhat. With regards to the energy market, we have the American Petroleum Institute weekly report on crude oil inventories, but as it is always the case, no forecast is currently available. As for the speakers, we have four on today's agenda: ECB President Christine Lagarde, Fed Chair Jerome Powell, ECB Chief Economist Philip Lane, and Philadelphia Fed President Patrick Harker. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm hosting every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.